Hi guys, welcome to Naresh AI Technologies. This is a second video session on HTML. In first video session, I made very clear about web terminologies. In this session, we'll try to observe related to HTML, HTML history, versions, HTML structure, tags and types of tags, how to create a web page. Initially, first we'll observe 1989 onwards, what are the changes occurred in the web environment? Generalized markup language. In the year of 1989, first markup related language. In this some loopholes, in 1991, Tim Berners-Lee, those loopholes recovered and renamed as SGML, Standard Generalized Markup Language. And in 1994, several loopholes available in SGML. These loopholes recovered and renamed as Hypertext Markup Language. Hypertext Markup Language is what exactly? Hypertext Markup Language, what is in simple definitions? So first, hypertext. Specially designed text for web browsers. Markup with meaningful tags or elements. Language in simple English language. This is HTML, simple definition. Hypertext means specially designed text for web browsers. Markup means with meaningful tags or elements. Language means in simple English language, and HTML definition, that is, or you can say simply hypertext markup language. In 1998, XML plus HTML is equal to XHTML, extended hypertext markup language. It is a drastical improved version in web environment. From this XHTML, there are the several features introduced to the IT industry. Those are SMS, short messaging services, MMS, multimedia messaging services, web services, electronic mail features, more integration occurred. And 1998, whatever the combination of XML and HTML released, extended hypertext markup language, and it is used to develop advanced level web pages compatible for several mobile as well as electronic devices. And in the year of 2008, nearly one decade after HTML 5.0 released. But documentation and full-fledged release is not in 2008, but 2008, in the year of 2008, HTML 5.0 entered into IT environment. So this is simple history related to HTML. Again, there are the several versions available. HTML 1.0, HTML 2.0, HTML 3.0, HTML 4.0 and HTML 5.0. Like this, several versions are there, and all the versions having the related features, basic features to complete advanced level features in the HTML 5.0. 1.0 level, completely basic environment, basic features. It is in 1994 the journey started. From there, 2.0, approximately I am giving years, 97. And 3.0, 98. And 4.0, 99. But approximately all the years, not exactly. So these years indicating when the particular version released and several features related to that particular version. All these versions released by W3C organization. W3C organization. Related to this organization, in previous video session, I made very clearly. World Wide Web Consortium. It is an organization to maintain web standards. It was founded in 1994 by Tim Berners-Lee. Generally, we are calling Sir Tim Berners-Lee. He is the father of web environment. Just once you are going to visit w3c.org, go to the related website w3c.org. It provides every information related to web environment, W3C logo, and it is providing information. Almost all, for every question, there is a solution available in this website. And here only there is a webplatform.org website available. If you are going to webplatform.org, it is a original website from W3C organization. Your web completely documented here. Hereafter you want to view any kind of tutorials related to web environment, better you can see the official website is webplatform.org. Your web documented. The latest information on how to use the technology that runs the web, HTML, CSS, JavaScript and many more available, including video sessions, including blog. And try to visit webplatform.org for web related information. It is related to W3C. W3C is nothing but, I made already, it is a simply owner of the web environment. It is maintaining web environment. Right. Now, whatever W3C organization information I've seen, up to all these versions, this organization responsibility. Right. HTML5 onwards, what are the organizations involved? What are the features entered? I'll upload separately video sessions only on HTML5, 5.1 and CSS 3 level and CSS 4 also. We'll see in separate. Now, I'm showing here, what are the tags available? How many types of tags available? Generally, tags are classified into the following two types. First one is paid tags. Second one is non-paid tags. Generally, these tags we are calling as elements also. In HTML environments, we are calling as a tags. Other than HTML elements, we are calling elements. Paid tags means what? Non-paid tags means what? A tag which is having opening tag as well as a closing tag. Opening tag as well as a closing tag. That is paid tag. Closing always left side forward slash. So every open tag you are closing means it is comes under paid tag. What is a non-paid tag? A tag which is having only opening, there is no closing, mainly left side. Those are called non-paid tags. For example, BR, break, it is a non-paid tag. HR, horizontal rule, is a non-paid tag. IMG, image, is a non-paid tag. Like this, several non-paid tags available. So basically, tags are classified into two types, paid and non-paid tags. Next, after these tags types, we'll observe the structure of HTML document. HTML inside head, title, commonly title available, and title you can add a title here, title close paid tag, then head close paid tag, after that body close, HTML close, and body here. Generally body here. Right. So HTML opened, HTML closed, head opened, head closed, title open, title close, body open, body close. All are paid tax. So this is the structure of HTML document. Every HTML document starts with HTML tag. It is the first tag in every HTML document. Every HTML document ends with HTML, forward slash HTML. In between, whatever the content available related to HTML property. And here, all are paid tax available. So here, there is no non-paid tag implemented. Now, add title here. Title is displaying on the top of the document, web document as a title, and body inside the body of the document means page. Now, in this structure, observe correctly, four elements are critical elements. These critical elements are popularly known as mandatory elements. Those are HTML, head, title, body. In any HTML document, these four elements are mandatory to say it is HTML document. These four elements are making it is web document. In these four elements, we are implementing again three kind of elements. Those are called opening tags, closing tags, and elements content. Now, in this simple session, I want to make sure this is, and these are the tags available here, 1, 2, 3, and this one, these are called opening tags, and here, and another one, title and head, plus these two, we are having here closing tags. Here available, these are two. This is called content. So these are the three parts mainly available here. First one is opening tags, second one is closing tags, third one is the content. Any HTML document you can view, these are the three parts available. Now, how to create a web page? Practically, step by step, we'll observe. Generally, to create a HTML page or to create a web page, various editors available, various IDEs available, integrated development environment. Different tools available, anyone we can use. As a learner, as a startup person, always recommended one is any editor. If you are using Windows operating system, and you should use Notepad. If you are using Unix operating system, go with VI editor. So every operating system, they have their own editors. You can run HTML even in your mobiles and smartphones and tablets also. Just go to Google and download Notepad for the related Android, Notepad for related iOS, Notepad for related BlackBerry. Download simply one-step installation available on the smartphone. There also we can implement. Maybe in another video session, I'll show you how to write HTML or HTML5 scripts inside the smartphones, tablets. First, we'll observe on the editor. Now, I'm selecting one common editor is Notepad in the Windows environment. Just I'm opening Notepad. Once you open text editor is a Notepad, it is popularly known as ASCII formatted file or flat file. It accepts only alphanumeric plus special characters. It's a perfect practice is Notepad for a learner. But real time industry completely we are using different IDEs and tools. Now untitled Notepad available. Now I am writing on this Notepad. First Step 1 is launch any text editor. Enter required HTML tags or elements. Step 3. Save with .html or .htm extension. Step 4. Right click on the saved file. Open with your desired browser. Any browser. Any major browser. Or whatever the browsers right now in the market available that you can use. Firefox, Google Chrome, IE, Edge. So latest version we are calling IE Edge, Opera, Apple Safari, UC, different browsers available. Now step 1 I am writing. I opened already. Launch any text editor. Notepad I opened. Step 2. Enter required HTML elements. Head, title and title close, head close and title inside my first web page, and I am opening body inside welcome to the world of web. Body close, HTML close. So every open tag, HTML opened, HTML closed, head opened, head closed, title opened, title closed, body opened, body closed, and title as well as body. So welcome to the world of web. Just go to file, click on save, enter file name, my first page or my page .html and select all files for better format. And if you are using other than English, other formats will select. I'll show you later that. And click on save. By default it is saving on the desktop, no issue. Click on save. Once you clicked on save, my page .html available here. I'm zooming that, I'm showing to you very closely, that is HTML. Created date and time clearly displays. Now right click on the file, several browsers opened. Open with any browser you can select. I am selecting Google Chrome. Yes, welcome to the world of web. And my first web page, come to open any other website, common website we are using, Google I opened. Inside the Google also what title available I'll show you. So my title is my first web page, and once you are coming to Google available. But here there is a small image you can observe. This is we are calling as favorite icon, favicon. In the real time industry we are using these favorite icons to close to our business. As per our client requirement we are creating these fav icons. Those fav icons practically you will see first my first web page title available. Now for example, I am opening one Facebook home page. Once you are entering into one Facebook home page and opening, and available here also. So when title unable to display here, one browser, one kind of behaving available. And for example, if I am selecting Firefox, and here three dots also displays, means when title unable to display, some browsers are indicating with three dots. And really, and your Firefox is doing or not like that, I'll try to open any website. For example, Facebook, number one social media website, social networking website, anyone we can say. So whenever unable to display completely, three dots are coming. These three dots I am zooming to you very close to you and observe. This is ellipsis we are calling. When title unable to display, three dots will come. Right, any website here available, again here also fav icon. Fav icon is a common business one. For example, I am opening bing.com. Right, So I'm opening other websites also to show you what is the clarity. So bing.com, again here also fav icon is going to be loaded. So once loaded fav icon, it will be small b, it displays. So like this, every website having title as well as the related fav icon. Now come to our title, whatever I created my first web page, welcome. Can I modify directly this text on the web page? No. Because by default a web page is read only. Of course we'll do read and write with the help of scripting. Right now it is read only. If you want to modify anything on this web page, open in the notepad format and do required modifications. Welcome to the world of Naresh I Technologies. Save it. Just come to your browser web page, refresh it. Perfectly it is working. This is a simple video session for very startup learner, how to create a web page and introduction about HTML. Thank you for watching my videos. Catch me for more videos on youtube.com/NareshIT.